The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Kevin in Orlando. Hey, Kevin, what's going on?
Hey, I'm doing great. You know, I am addicted to TFNN.
We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. It's a great network, man. And I want to thank everyone out there, you know, for making it a great network.
Well, it's great because I do outside sales, so I get to have the station on my phone the whole day. And when I go pick up the kids at from school at 3 o'clock, they all love and give the old ram. Educating the kids at a young age is a good thing.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's the first day of summer, folks. What a beautiful thing that is. Become a servant of love. Love is what makes you happy, and if you become a servant of love, and your partner becomes a servant of love, the day will come when you can be with your partner with no guilt, no blame, no anger, and no sadness. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 199, NASDAQ up 59, S&P's up 24, gold contract down $3.70, traded at $1,291 an ounce. Silver up 10 cents at $17.51 an ounce. Platinum up $16 at $9.86 an ounce. Copper up 4 pennies at $2.09 a pound. Light sweet crude up $1.27, $49.25 a barrel. Bonds, the 10-year notes, down 12 ticks, 131.15. 30-year bond off a full point, 2 ticks, 168.03. Both the note and the bond, folks, down on light volume. They still want higher price, lower yield. King dollar. King dollar down 650 ticks, trading at 93.69. The euro is up 36 at 113, and the yen is trading at 103.96. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, can you say failure, folks? You got it all over the place. Pretty wild. Market opens up this morning. Big numbers in the S&P. Failed on price, failed on volume. You get a bear market bounce here. Vicious bounce, no doubt. But guess what? It can't even hold the swing high from the C point of this ABC structure on the way down. If we take a look at the SPY traded to a high today of 209.61. You're at 208.64. You're going to do, who knows, maybe 80 million shares. You're going into 100 million. We hit a low with 149 million. You still got an ABC structure on the way down. Your price projection here is 204 to 202. NDX 100, same setup in the NDX 100. NDX 100 got to a price point today of $108.24. Now, what was really cool about the NDX couldn't even make the swing point, which is pretty wild. The swing point on the NDX, just from the C point, is 108.44. Bottom line, you made 108.24. That just goes to show how weak it is. NDX 100, 3 Qs, they're heading down to the 105.70 area, to the 104. The swing points that we're talking about there are the December 19th swing points. Gold contract, what do we have with gold? Gold, folks, wants higher price. The gold contract right now is, it traded to a low today of $1,280. You're at $1,291. We've done 182,000 contracts. Bottom line, XAU, HUI, GLD, gold contract all broke their highs last week with monster volume. Gold's on its way to 1,428. They're huge ABC structures on the way up, folks. Notes, what do we have with the note market? This is what you have with the note market. You get the 10-year note. You're backing down today. You're down 11 ticks. We have 875,000 contracts. You're going into 1.6 million contracts, so it's pretty intense. We are at a price point of 131.16. 131.02 can be tested. Bottom line, you're backing down with dramatically lighter volume. That's the 10-year note. The 30-year bond, what we have with the 30-year bond is this. 30-year bond also is backing down with dramatically lighter volume. We've done 187,000 contracts out here today. You reached a low of 167.20. You're at 168 right now. And we are backing down with 188,000 contracts versus 271,000. The notes and the bonds, folks, still want higher price. King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar? Let's go take a look at King Dollar. DXU6. King Dollar right now is trading out at a price point down 655 ticks. We're at 93.68. You've done 19,000 contracts. The swing low that it's going after right now is 93.38. I suspect it's going to wake up tomorrow morning and wouldn't like to jump that creek of 93.38, make its way down to the 92 area, which is the high volume swing low on this contract from May 3rd. That being said, larger picture, folks, looks that King Dollar wants to make it down to the 88 area. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. I know what's going on in your world. If we go to the world of the E-minis, what I expect you're going to see here, folks, is more selling as we come into the close out here. This is going to be a major failure. You know, if you were in front of a screen this morning, these markets were up good point-wise, but all they actually did was get to the swing point of last week, and they failed. They failed on price, failed on volume, all of the above. What we did do on Friday, you talk about monster volume. It was option expiration, but we hit lows on the NYSE with 2.1 billion shares versus 893. You take a look at the NASDAQ composite, what we did with the composite. You got into lower price, and the composite did 2.6 billion shares. So bottom line, big, big numbers. Inside the Dow Industrials out here today, the strength. Every Dow stock is positive, folks. There's not a one Dow stock that's not positive. You are up 193 points right now. Boeing is the leader. That's up 2.6%. The laggard is Cisco. That's up 0.1 of 1%. Inside the NDX 100, what do we have? Inside the NDX, this morning you had each and every 100 stocks were up, bottom line. Now we get a few that are down. You got Endo Pharmaceuticals down 1.6%. Netflix is off 0.2%. Most of them are up, though, because you can see even the second one out of 99 is only down 0.2%. The leaders out here, what do you have? JD.com up 5.7%. eBay's up 3.7%. Expedia is up 3.5%. And Ctrip is up 3.4%. If we go over to Expedia just for a second, let me look at this thing. Okay, so you get a consolidation in Expedia. This wants to get up to the 117 level. We'll see whether it can crack that 117 level. Some of the higher volume stocks in this low volume market, because you have a low volume counter trend bouncing a huge way out here today. We have Marathon Oil is up a buck and a half. You have Bank of America up 18 cents. General Electric's up 40 cents. You have Citigroup up 44 cents. Pfizer's up 38. If we go over and we take a look at the XLF, those financials, financials also failed on price, failed on volume. They went into the swing point of 2303, you hit 2309. We're at 2283. You did 45 million shares. It would have to get over 55 million and it's not gonna happen. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are down, up 194. NASDAQ's up 57. S&P's are up 23. We'll be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 177. You get the Nasdaq up 51. S&Ps are up 21. If we go over to the S&Ps first, let's take a look at these E-minis as we're coming into the close. You're going to see some selling here, folks. What we just did is that we just took a small B point out of an ABC down intraday, and it has the volume behind the move. So it can get, let's see, 92, you get 12 bucks, 75. $4.72. We can get down to $20.72, and right now we're $20.80. So that's going to be it's going to be interesting to see how that whole thing shakes out. That's on the S&P. So $20.72. We're $20.81 right now. That'll be quite a way down. The NDX. NDX has done the exact same setup. The NDX took out its B point of an ABC structure on the way down intraday. Did it with volume. That setup, that's almost there. The NDX A to B equals C to D is at 4,400. We're 4,408. They just took that south pretty quick. That just went from 4,420 to 4,408. Has the juice behind the move, and there's not much that can save this down. Actually, that can get down into 4,394. Actually, it can get even, yeah, it can get a little bit lower. But it's taking the B point out, taking it out with volume, all of the above. The from the highs to lows out here today, this is going to be pretty intense, actually. The Dow hasn't given it up yet. You know, the high in the Dow today is 17,946. You're at 17,854. You know, so you're 90 points off the high. NDX, different ballgame. If we take a look at the composite next. Composite gave it up. Composite. The high was 48.82, and right now we're at 48.52. So it's 30 points off that high. The NDX 100, the high of the day was 44.44, and that has given it up. We're at 44.14. You know, so that had got over the C point of last week, which was the 44.39. Has lighter volume. This is still an ABC structure on the way down, and that ABC wants to bring it down to the 42.82 area. So you can expect some high volatility the rest of this week. And so what we do have is this. Tomorrow you get a couple of the Fed, well, one Fed governor speaking, as well as Janet Yellen. She's out there. She's out there testifying, I believe. Yeah, that's the first day of testimony in Congress. So that's going to be Tuesday, Wednesday. That's big action. Thursday is the Britain exit vote. That's going to be big action. And what will happen on that is that we will actually get those numbers at approximately, I think it's going to be 5 o'clock our time, after our market actually closed. So that's going to bring volatility into this market the whole rest of the week. If we go, let me take a look at that dollar index. Bottom line, dollar can't hold higher price, folks. This is going to be wild watching this whole thing shake out. What you can expect, though, is that the ABC structures, they're ABC structures down. They turned into, I'm going to go through this SPY for you, because they're all like this. Okay. So what happened with the SPY? SPY had come down off the high. So the SPY made its high on June 8th. That high was $212.52. It comes off that high and comes down with volume. Does a counter trend bounce? When I say with volume, it come down with 125 million shares. Does a counter trend bounce and goes up with 109 million. Breaks the swing, which makes an ABC structure on the way down, and does it with volume. We broke down with 149 million. Now, a complex ABC, folks, goes like this. This is on the way down or the way up. A complex ABC down, I'm going to talk about first, is that you break the B point with volume, and then it doesn't hold price. So it does a counter trend bounce that gets higher, which we did on the 16th of June. Deviant marketplace, no doubt. It's pretty cool. Complex ones are pretty cool in the context of watching how they play out. So then what do? On Friday, you come down. We didn't get to a lower low. Today, you got over the C point of that ABC structure on the way down. That C point was $209.39. We got to $209.61. And guess what? It's even going to be lighter volume. So now what you have is this, is that now you're at 59 million. The C point in itself had 109 million, which was light volume in itself. And guess what? It's failed on price, failed on volume. And what does that set up? Well, that is still an ABC structure on the way down. And that ABC is saying that it wants to go down to the 204 to 202 level, which is the high volume swing point from the 19th of May. And then the larger picture, remember, folks, is that we get all those high volume swing lows down in October of 11th, as well as January 20th. Bottom line is that you can see these counter trend bounces are fast, furious, all of the above. And then when it gives it up in spades. We go over that. So that's your SPY. If you look at the NQs are even weaker. The NQs, they couldn't make the C point on the counter trend bounce today. The C point on the NQs was $108.44. We went to $108.24. You'd done 15 million shares. That C point up there had 24 million. Guess what? You can't make it. You're already inside the lower side of this ABC structure on the way down. That is saying that also wants to go down. Now, depending on how much more we sell off into the close, and it looks to me like we're going to sell off quite a bit, what you're going to see is this. If, in fact, we sell off, let me see this, NQU. If you sell off too much, this will gap away on the way down tomorrow. Because the way that this went higher today at the open, there's probably plenty of folks that bought it just to, you know, trade it for a few days. But what you're going to see happen here is that when you get a market that's up, and, you know, there's plenty of professionals that are day trading all day long, and you get it up, and there's enough news out there, and the European markets did stay higher, okay, that probability goes higher that you're going to run up all day long. Well, it didn't work today. So what happens when it doesn't work is that you got everyone in the market, they bought the market, they were going to push, and it flips the other way. That accelerates the selling on the way down, because you're going to see plenty of folks that were just trading, and they got to get out. They don't have to get out, okay, but they will get out. They want to have some bread for tomorrow morning. And that will accelerate the selling on the way down, because thus far, what you're going to see out here is that when we opened this morning, we opened at 43.83. Well, the way this market's trading right now, it looks to me like it's going to make us run all the way back down into that level. And if that's what you get, we'll get a gap down tomorrow. Why? Because two different things end up happening. That's a total failure on price, total failure on volume, and you have an ABC structure that is already confirmed on the way down. It's turned into a complex one. It's done it twice, and you've got King Dollar that wants to go to hell in a handbag. And so those correlations, and you get the bonds that want to go higher. All those correlations, you put those correlations together, bottom line, we got lower markets coming at us. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 169. NASDAQ's up 48. S&P's are up 20. We're going to be right back, folks.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, many commodities are trading at relative lows. And now you can take advantage with EverBank's new limited-time, 5-year, market-safe currency comeback CD. This indexed and U.S. dollar-denominated CD offers 100% principal protection and is based on the equally rated performance of currencies of Australia, Canada, Chile, Mexico, and South Africa. These five countries are especially rich in commodities, and their respective currencies are poised to do well should commodity prices begin to recover. Keep in mind that no APY, or periodic rate of interest, is paid on the CD. Don't miss out on this innovative new financial opportunity. CDs must be opened and funded by the upcoming July 14th deadline. To apply online and learn more about the CD, including product terms and disclosures, visit everbank.com/TFNN now. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We get the Dow up 165. NASDAQ's up 45. S&Ps are up 19.5. If you go over to the NQs for a second, what you're going to see is that we're just about finishing up that ABC structure that we were talking about intraday. The price projection on that, folks, is 43.98. We've hit 4,400, I believe. You've hit 4,401 at this point. I expect you're going to see that, though. You're going to get that. And the real question is going to be, with a half hour left, will it get into the 43-83 area? It's going to be interesting watching this thing shake out. We go take a look at the E-minis. What you have with the E-minis right now is this. E-minis also had broken that B point of an ABC structure on the way down. The difference with the E-minis is that we had, well, let's see. So 92 was your A. Your B was 81, so you get $11, which gives you 2073. And right now, we are at 2078. We hit a low of 2078. So 2073 would be the number on that E-mini. So we'll see where this shakes out. There's plenty of time to do a little counter-trend bounce with light volume, set up the next ABC structure on the way down. Volume-wise out here, what you're going to see inside the indices out here today is, one second, MVOLNE. Right now, we're only at $590 million on the NYSE. So that's saying that's going to come in about $800 million. That's going to be, of course, when we come down to $2.1 billion, you go up at $800 million. See ya, don't want to be ya. We go take a look at the NASDAQ composite. That, we're at $1.4 billion. That'll come in with about $1.8 billion. You go down with $2.6 billion, you go up with $1.8. That is the same type of situation, meaning that they got them caught on the upside buying this, and I suspect it's going to go south. If we go over to the XLF, the financials, what you have with the financials is this. The XLF had traded to a price point today of $23.09. Also got into the C of an ABC structure on the way down. It couldn't get through a high of that, though. That high out there was the high was $23.30. We got to a price point of $23.09. You know, the volume's not bad on the XLF. Now, this is where, so watch how this shakes out now. So what we have is that we had come down, it's 45 million, you're going against 54. So if you get a close under $23.03 with less than 54 million shares, that is a failure on price and on volume. The XLE also, now the XLE got some juice, meaning no, price-wise, but has zero juice behind it. We're up on 8 million shares. You're going into 14 million. And 67, 65 we're at. Actually, this is pretty cool. If it closes below 67, 77, that's a failure also. Let's go to Dave in Boston. Hey, Dave, what's going on?
How are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing good, thanks. Doing good. I just want to see if you can take a quick look at Starbucks for me. Having a hard time getting over this 56. I'm thinking about buying some puts on it.
Let's take a look. We get Starbucks. The low for the year is 42. The high is 64. It's trading at $55.49. Oh, yeah, nice. Oh, I like it. Yeah, I can. This is intense. Okay, so watch this, folks. You've got the $56.28 today. That got it over the high of last week, which had 7.4 million. These are 5.5. Also got it over the high of the 7th. Yeah, and it has that high volume swing low, man, of 54 to 52. You know, if you're going to get the, I wouldn't go too, what strike price are you going to go after?
I'm going to go in the money. I'm going with the 56, probably the August 56.
Yeah, I think that'll be good, man. Because this is what you have. See, the high of the low here is 54, 47, and that's what's been kind of hanging that up, you know, building cars there. That's why it's been stopping.
You think we'll get it to 50 bucks?
It's a close one, man. See, when you get a high volume, what you have is this. As the market does, these high volume lows in February and January are pretty intense. But the what happens with a high volume low, folks, is that the top of that bar also is big support. And in Starbucks' case, every time it comes down to that $54.47 area, it bounces off it with dramatically lighter volume. So that's what's holding this up right now.
Right.
And so what to do, as long as you, I think where you're going in, the 56 is a good deal, because what happens is this. If it, well, when it comes back down to the highs of the low, if it doesn't have the volume, just close it out, man, and do it again.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
It's just gonna, you know, so, you know.
Okay.
Okay, man.
All right, thanks, Tom.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. You got the Dow up $1.70, NASDAQ up 44. S&Ps are up 19 right now. And XAU, the HUI, folks, if you're in the metals market, okay, this is about as cool as you can get. These are monsters, folks. They're monster ABC structures on the way up. They took the B point out. They took them out with volume. Now, this will be a long, this is a much longer ABC structure on the way up. Bottom line is that we did 445 million shares last week on the XAU, taking out the B point of 270 million. That's your XAU, the HUI, the Gold Bugs contract. What did you do? Gold Bugs, isn't that a funny name? So the Gold Bugs contract, same type of setup. What we did with the Gold Bugs contract is this. We did volume of 255 million, taking out the B point of 146 million. Now remember something, we went sideways for, 9 weeks. You know, bottom line, you went sideways for 9 weeks. The A to B is a straight line move, sideways for 9 weeks, and we'll see whether this is the C to D of that monster ABC up. But it looks to me that's exactly what we have happening. The dollar index is cooperating. So the dollar index, how we come down is going to—it's cooperating at this particular point. When you do look at the dollar, it looks to me that this dollar wants to get into not only just the swing low that was generated out here and this past June. It looks to me like we're going down into the highs of 2008, 9, and 10, which is 88. And you know, bottom line, if you pierce 88. You can make the real case really, really quick that you're going to be about 82 inside this dollar index. So there's going to be a lot. There is a lot of action out here all across the currencies, the markets, and the metals. If we go look at the GLD, what you're also going to see is that inside the GLD, they're trading at $123.09. The GLD also had monster volume. The GLD took out its B point. You had 81 million shares versus 56 million. So bottom line is that, you get a lot of harmony in this marketplace right now. And sometimes when you get too much harmony, it's almost scary. But bottom line, that's what you do get. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow Industrials are up 173. NASDAQ's up 45. S&Ps are up 20. You stay right there, folks. We come right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD.
For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow right now is up 179. You get the NASDAQ up 48. S&Ps are up 21. Let's go to Janet in British Columbia. Hey, Janet, what's going on?
Hello, Tom. Long time since I've been on talking to you, but you're on every day.
How you been?
Pretty good, thank you. These are crazy markets.
Yeah, I like hearing your voice. Thank you for calling.
Oh, you're welcome. Could you look at Avino Silver for me? I'm thinking about maybe getting in.
Okay, so let's take a look. It's ASM, Avino Silver. They do business in Mexico. It's a silver mine. The low for the year is 71 cents. The high is $2.60. And they are a production company, folks. They're taking in approximately $36 million this year. Right now, they're running about $12 million per quarter. Okay, so, you know, like all the rest of the golds and silvers, they've had quite a run. I mean, this already, you know, just went from 70 cents to 260.
Right.
You know, so it's like, you know, the buy here is between 195 and 173. Because up here, man, woman, it's dangerous, you know. Yeah, and it might, I know, you know, these are ABC structures on the way up, and they might not pull back, but, you know, it's the danger is that buying something that just, you know, doubled in price in 2 weeks is pretty intense, man. I would wait.
You'd wait?
Yeah. You have to wait. Because the risk versus the reward is not worth it. You know.
Okay.
And that's even with me. I know I'm saying this is an ABC structure on the way up, and to me it is. But guess what? If it isn't, then, you know, you can be toast in about 2 seconds buying these highs.
Mm-hmm. I thought it looked like an ABC up because it was backing off as it was going down, you know, but...
No, I agree. I agree. The difference is that this can be a normal retracement. And, you know, when you go from 70 cents to 270, this can be a normal retracement and come back to 173 pretty easily.
Sure enough. You know. So maybe Hecla or GPL or something.
Hecla let me see Hecla. Hecla could have been bought this morning. Hecla's a good situation. You can still buy. This is what the difference is. Now, this gets interesting, folks. Hecla also has gone up dramatically from 148 to 460. The difference is Hecla, you can put a stop under 406. So you get a 60 cent stop and you're at 460. Hecla's in a confirmed ABC structure on the way up. So watch this. The difference is that you push last week with 68 million, and you're dealing with an ABC that I believe it's a $9 ABC. Let me see, 1 second. Oh, you got 145. So you got...
I think you said 7-Eleven on your gold report.
No, that's what it is, a 7-Eleven. That's my point. So the risk versus the reward's there, but what you also have is that you have support underneath you that you can put a stop at where ASM doesn't. You see what I'm saying?
Right, yeah, I do.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
Very definitely.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Hey, listen, how are things in British Columbia?
They're good. Weather's been good. Too dry, you know.
Okay.
Same as everywhere else. But,
yeah.
No, we're looking for probably a long, dry summer, I would think.
Okay. I like that.
No. Yeah. Have you ever been up our way?
No, but I have three pictures in my office of the harbor there. It's gorgeous. I look at them every day.
Now, are you talking Vancouver Harbor or the Victoria Harbor?
Victoria Harbor.
Oh, yeah, that's where you need to come.
Yeah.
Well, they're both really nice, but
yeah.
Victoria outdoes Vancouver, in
yeah,
my
no,
opinion.
Yeah, that Victoria Harbor reminds me of, like, the Vineyard way out at Menemsha. I mean, it's a real fishing village. That's what I'm looking at anyway, right.
So when are you coming up?
Oh, I don't know, man. I know. I gotta go to a lot of places.
You have to let me know when you're coming up.
I will if I get up there, which I will. Seriously.
Oh, good.
Okay.
Terrific.
Great talking to you.
Thanks.
Have a great
Tom.
One.
Bye-bye.
Have a safe one. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. The NASDAQ, the S&Ps, yeah, they're all giving it up, folks. We're at 2078 in the S&P. And not that that's a lot. What happens is that when you do have a market that tries to get the highs, can't handle it, you get a sell-off. After that, it's a problem. That's where this whole thing stands right now, folks. The bonds continue to say they want higher price. And these bonds at higher price are just a whole different animal. You know, if we take a look at the rate structure right now, you're at 1.6 in the 10-year, and that still is huge compared to the rest of the first world. That's what it comes down to. France is still at 0.4%. Germany is 0.05%. It's like, oh, really? You know, so the ironic part about it is that, you know, when you hear on the financial press on a continual basis that there's no inflation out there, I don't know where they're looking. That's the real bottom line. I really don't know where they're looking, because if you are sending children to school, you get inflation up the yin yang. If you are buying a house or renting house, you get inflation. If you're buying real food instead of instead of wheat, you're paying big money, folks. That's the bottom line. And to me, inflation is out here, and it's out here in spades, big time, too. 877-927-6648. The NQ, it looks like we're going to get that. I think we just got the 4398. We did. So the NQ's just finished an ABC structure on the way down from when we started, but it looks to me like it just started another one. It did. Oh, my God. Yeah, these NQs are going to give it up. These NQs were at 43.96, and now you get 43.83 as game. If it's, let's see, man, you still got, we get 12 minutes left. Well, you get 12 minutes to the close. The futures don't close until quarter past. You know, if you get into too heavily this 43.91 area, man, this thing could fill the whole gap, which would just be a total mind blower, you know. Why? Because the amount of money that they took in so quick is pretty incredible. Let me go look at one of the ticks out here. One of the tigers is saying we got 1,400 tick. Oh, that's a disaster. So check this out, yeah. So you get a plus 1,347 tick, folks. And we haven't got a down tick yet. Let me just see when that was, though. Okay, so watch this. You can't pay attention to ticks at the open, either down ticks or up ticks. So the way that the tick works, and that was at the open, folks, this is what happens. The opening tick, so this is what the tick is. The tick is the amount of equities that are getting bought or sold on the bid or the offer. And when there is a plus tick like that, that means that they're getting bought at the offer, okay? You do not pay attention to it at the open, because at the open, everything is always skewed. You know, if it's down, of course, it's going to be 1,400, 1,500 down. You have to have the market opened, so then simultaneously, and this is where we are all one, okay? If you want to get your head wrapped around us all being one, well, guess what? Fear and greed in the marketplace is the easiest way to put that helmet on, and you'll see how this is, because the fear and greed somehow takes place exactly the same time. That's when those ticks are really valuable. as to releasing information in the marketplace. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials are down, up 139. Nasdaq's up 38. S&Ps are up 16. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow right now is up 129. You get the Nasdaq up 34. S&Ps are up 15. And bottom line, you get quite a sell-off here, folks. If we go over to the Dow Industrials, we take a look at the Dow from highs to lows out here. This is what you have. The Dow Industrials did make it up to 17,946, and it's sold off 146 points from then. We're at 17,806 right now, and that also is a failure on price, failure on volume. Inside the NASDAQ composite, what do we have with the composite? Composite, same type of setup. Composite made it up to a price point of 48.82. And that sold off, let's say, 84. Yeah, it sold up 48 points. We right now are at 48.34. That continues to be that ABC structure on the way down. The NDX 100, what we have with the NDX, that give it up in spades, man. The NDX, was the high today was 44.44. Right now we're at 43.98. So that's given up 46 points. And the NDX is actually into the highs of Friday. So the NDX also continues that ABC structure on the way down. We go take a look at the bonds. The bonds still want higher price. King dollar hasn't moved much. What I do expect, you're going to see some movement in that. Some of the other Dow stocks out here, and we had, when we started the program, let's look at it now. When we started the program, every Dow stock was positive. Now what we do have, well, let's see. We still might have every Dow stock still. No, now what you do have, you have Cisco is down 0.5%. You have Apple off 0.2%. Microsoft's down 0.1%. Procter & Gamble's down 0.1%. Not that that's a big amount. It's not. It's not even close. If we do take a look at Apple came down Friday, came down with volume. Apple's making its way down to this lower swing point from May 12th. That swing point, the high of that swing is 92, the low is 89, and that's where that looks like it wants to go. That's on a short-term basis. Longer term, it very well is probably trying to crack this bottom out here of 89. Google's got some big problems. Google, you talk about going south on volume Friday. Google is a monster, man. Google came down, folks, on 3.4 million shares, got to 688, breaking the 689 level and breaking it with volume. Google's making its way down to this 663 area. That is going to present huge problems for the NDX 100. Bottom line is that, I suspect the next stop on this is like 674. And if Google breaks into 674, get out of the way. Because that's where Google last July had gone from a price point of 532 to 674 nonstop. It was a nice break topside. Ended up going, not only, it went from $500 all the way up to $789. Now it's making its way, back down to the other side. So it's pretty intense watching this whole thing shake out. The volume out here today is going to be light going across the board inside the NYSE. We're dealing with, it looks like it should do $800 million. Right now you're at $672. I expect we're going to do $800 million. If we don't do $800 million, man, get out of the way. It's going to be even sicker. Why? Because the more that the volume contracts when you do a counter trend bounce is telling you what? It's telling you that the market is even weaker than just a normal bounce. Because markets love to breathe, folks. Okay, they breathe on the way up, they breathe on the way down. The composite looks like it's going to do about $1.8 billion, which is normal for a counter trend bounce out here. If we go and we take a look at the oil market now, the oil market has hung in there. Oil went up, but it has light volume, but guess what? It hung in there. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now are up 138. NASDAQ is up 38. S&Ps are up 16. We're going to be right back, folks.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Alex in Newton. Hey, Alex, what's going on, brother?
Hi, Tom. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good, man.
Subscribe for your gold report. I've been following you for a while. The first time I subscribed for it. And what I love about your gold report is that you give us a direction. You give us an overview of the whole market. And you leave final decision to us because you give a lot of ideas. After that, you can choose whatever. Whatever you want to follow, whatever you don't.
Yeah.
That is great.
Okay, brother.
Thank you.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
Thanks.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's the first day of summer, folks. Let's make it a great one. For all those folks out in the West, man, we got to send them some cool weather, man. It's breaking records out there. Bad scene. To master love, you have to practice love. The art of relationship is a whole mastery, and the only way to reach mastery is with practice. To master a relationship is therefore about action. It is not about attaining knowledge. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish up 129, NASDAQ up 36, S&P's up 13, gold contract down $1.60, trading at $1,293 an ounce. Silver up 11 cents at $17.52 an ounce. Platinum up $16 at $9.85 an ounce. Copper up 3.5 pennies at $2.08 a pound. Light sweet crude up $1.20, trading at $49.18 a barrel. Notes down 13 ticks, 131.14. Bonds up a full point, 9 ticks, 167.28. Both the notes and the bonds back down today, dramatically lighter volume. They want higher price, lower yield once again. King dollar down 645 ticks, 93.69. King dollar can't handle higher price. King dollar is going after its May swing low of 92 on this contract. What I expect you're going to see, the way the metals are trading, the way that the dollar is trading, is that it wants to get down into that 88 area, which is the highs of 2008, 9, and 10. Euro is trading at $1.13, and the yen is at 103. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, can you say failure? Failure on price, failure on volume. You get an ABC structure on the way down. They took them in, they sucked them in, bought at the open and took them to the cleaners, folks. Bottom line, and the S&P, this is what you had. You had the European markets up 3% at our open this morning. S&P futures opened up 27, went up to 30, only ended up 15. You failed on price, failed on volume. The SPYs, what do the SPYs do? Okay, SPYs got to a price point today of $209.61, which got us over the C point of this ABC structure on the way down, which is $209.36. Guess what? You get over it, you closed under it, you did 78 million shares versus the 109 million shares, which is light volume. You still got a complex ABC structure on the way down. Your price projection is 204 to 202. NDX 100, same type of setup. Inside the NDX, is much weaker than the SPY. NDX, 3Qs. 3Qs, the C point on the 3Qs was $108.44. We only got to $108.24, so it couldn't even make the C point. We had volume of 20 million versus 24. So you gave it up on price, gave it up on volume. You're at $107.16. That's making its way down into this $105 to $104. The swing points that we're talking about on a short-term basis is the swing lows from the 19th of May. Gold contract, what do we have with gold? Gold wants higher price. You have the gold contract, the XAU, the GLD, the HUI, all doing ABC structures on the way up. On the weekly basis last week, it had it all, folks. Had volume, had price, had all the above. What we did out here today is that gold got down to 1280, rejected lower price, had lighter volume. Gold is on its way up to this 1428 area. Right now we're trading at 1293. And what's it all about? Well, let's go over to the note market. Bottom line, man, is that they can't crack this note market or the bond market. This is what we have. The notes today went down to a low of 131.11. We're at 131.14. You did 934,000 contracts. Now, this can get down to 131.02, which is another 12 ticks lower. You'll see the correlation. The correlation is pretty intense. You came down with 934,000 contracts versus 1.6 million. Okay, so big numbers. No sellers. Inside the 30-year bond, same set type of setup inside the 30-year. 30-year gets down a point and 10 ticks. We do that with 203,000 contracts versus 330,000 contracts versus 276,000 contracts. Bottom line, you're going to need a lot more contracts to get down and break this uptrend that has been in place for years. Big time. King dollar. What do we have with King dollar? Bottom line, folks, DXU, King dollar wants lower price. King dollar out here is trading. It traded down to 93.54 today. The swing point that it's going after is 93.38. We did 20,000 contracts, which is not a lot on the way down, by the way, okay? You know, as you know, it's going into 27,000. So what I expect you're probably going to see tomorrow is this. It's going to build a few little cars, 2 or 3 days, sideways movement, and then jump the creek. The creek that's set up here is about 93.40. We got to 93.50 today. What I expect you're going to see is that we're going to go after the swing low from May 3rd. That's the smaller issue. The larger issue looks like it's going to go after the 88 price point. That 88 price point was the highs of 2008, 2009, and 2010. Oil, let's go over to the oil contract and take a look at oil. Now, oil caught a bid, and the bid stayed there. Volume-wise, no, it didn't have it. Well, let me make sure I get the right contract we're trading. Oil changes every month, so oil, okay. Yeah, we're still on the right contract. Okay, so what we had out here is this. You did 431,000 contracts, and you're pushing into 49.45. You made it through. So, hey, yeah, no, this. Okay, so this gets game that oil is going to try to get up and into this $50.83 once again. That's how this is shaking out right now. So that'd be saying oil wants to go to the lows of the high that was generated out here on the 9th of June. It hasn't helped the market yet, and we'll see whether, if in fact, it can help this market. Volume-wise out here today, this is what you did. All the indices, all the ETF structures did light volume. On the NYSE, we did $908 million on the way up versus $2.1 billion on the way down on Friday. On the NASDAQ Composite, what we did, you did $1.7 billion on the way up versus $2.6 billion on the way down. Bottom line, folks, NASDAQ, S&Ps, Dow Industrials, small caps, are all ABC structures on the way down. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials closed up 129. NASDAQ up 36. S&P's up 15. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow finish up 129, NASDAQ up 36, S&P's up 15.5. If we bisect and dissect a few of the sectors inside the S&P, we'll start with the financials, folks, and this is what you have inside the financials. Financials, the XLF today got to a high of $23.09. The C point of this ABC structure on the way down was 23.30. So as the NDX 100 couldn't make the C point of a complex ABC down, the financials also didn't make it. And then what that sets up is a very weak market. So we got to a price point of 23.09. You closed at 22.74. And bottom line, this is making its way down to these 21.85 level. You know, you gave it up on volume. You gave it up. We did 57 million. Actually, what we did do is this: you had 57 million, which is good volume. It was going into 54, but then it gave it up on price. So now, what's going to happen? This is going to be really interesting, man. If it blows away this other swing point of 22.38, but that's what it looks like. And what we do have is you have that high volume swing low that's laying out there at the February 11th, and that the high of that low is $19.88, and the low is $19.53. Deviant market out here, folks. There's no doubt about it. The XLE, so inside the energies, what do we have? Energies got the XLE got to a price point of 68, and it's really surprising that it couldn't gap higher than that, and then it failed. You closed at $67.47. It couldn't hold the C point, which was $67.77. That's still an ABC structure on the way down, you know. So this little baby is making its way down into the $60 to $59. Well, first off, you'd go after the high volume swing low of $63.50. But that also couldn't handle higher price, which is just pretty. Inside the energies, that's incredible because of the fact that the oil price was up. The transports. Transports are in tough shape. Transports also couldn't hold price. The transports got to a price point today of $77.57. You closed at $76.72, and looks like the transports, they're going to make their way down into, this one's going to get interesting because you did push, yeah, it broke the swing. So the transports, $81.49. Oh man, this can get down quite a bit. So you're talking $600. We're talking $6,800. What is this? Yeah, the same deal. Transports are going after the swing lows also. These swing lows that were generated out here on the January and February, folks, they want to get hit. Now, let's go overseas, because what we had overseas, and this is where this gets, let's do this. We'll go to the Nikkei first. We'll go as to where everything opens up. So Nikkei right now traded up $365 last night. And what we had is that you had light volume. So the Nikkei is just about at its high volume swing low from February. The top of that is 15,400. We had hit 15,400 last Thursday. That's going to come right back at it. Why, folks? Because when we came down 1.5 billion. We just bounced last night with 1.3. The 1.3 was going against the 1.3 as well as the 1.5, failed on price. We're going to be right back down to those levels, and we'll see how it handles that high volume swing from February. We go to the Hang Seng. So the Hang Seng also, the Hang Seng got a nice bounce last night. That was up 340 points at 20,510. And the Hang Seng also had lighter volume. This is mild, man. So the Hang Seng looks like it can bounce a little bit higher. So we're at 20,510, 20,664 is game. Now let's go to the UK, because percentage-wise, this is what we had happening out here. And this is where the failure in our markets is pretty dramatic. The FTSE was up 3% today. The CAC in France was up 3.5%. The DAX was up 3.4%. Spain was up 3.4%. When you have those markets, well, here, let's go through those markets. So those markets closed at their highs, or very near their highs. Our markets said, see ya, don't want to be ya. Now, what we also have is this. The FTSE was up $182. We're at $6,200. Well, the FTSE didn't make its swing point. So first it has to go up to 6,322. Which is another 122 points. We'll see how it handles it. I suspect it's going to go after it tomorrow. We'll see whether it can handle it. The DAX in Germany. What do we have with DAX in Germany? What we have with the DAX in Germany, that was up 330 points at 99.62. Now, the DAX in Germany, the swing point is 10,365. But the DAX in Germany, when it broke its prior swings on Wednesday, it broke them with volume. So the DAX in Germany is saying it still wants to go down into its lower February swing area. You know, that being said, we'll see if it can get a little bit higher first. The whole bounce out here this morning, folks, we're going to be bouncing all over the place. The news part of the bounce this morning was saying that the people that want to move out of the British Union versus don't was getting closer. The last week, the vote was the people that want exit was 10 points higher. This morning, it was only 2 points higher. So bottom line, we'll see where this whole thing does shake out. But you can expect high volatility. Now, what we have tomorrow morning is this. Tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock, Janet Yellen starts talking in front of Congress. She talks Tuesday and Wednesday, both days. Thursday, that's the vote to leave or stay in the British Union. We're going to get those numbers at 5 o'clock Eastern time in the afternoon. And, of course, Friday, everyone's going to know where that is shaking out. So you can see there's going to be high volatility in spades. And, of course, what happens in the summer, it's very unusual when you get high volatility on a Monday or on a Friday. But this week, you can expect it, and I mean expect it in spades. If we go over to the small caps and we take a look at the IWM, what you're going to see with the IWM is that that also failed on price, on volume. The IWM was going into 36 million shares. That high was, it's not the high, but it was what it went into was $116.18. We went to $116.45 with 28 million. Couldn't handle the price of $116.18. Closed at $115.30. What do you have? You have an ABC structure on the way down. These are all complex ABCs. They had already broken the B point and rejected a low, went above it again, did it again this morning, rejected it again. And each and every time that you get a rejection, folks, you want to wrap your head around that, because what ends up happening is that you can get many traders on the wrong side very quickly, and then they got to get off and get in the right side. And that's what you saw coming into the close out here today. So if we do look at that close, what you're going to see, because we had a gap open today, when the market didn't hold, particularly because, you know, the European markets, that's what all that selling was into the close today. You know, they were all in a losing position, and they said, hey, guess what, man? I'm going to start again tomorrow. I'm not going to hold this position overnight, because we very well could be gapping down tomorrow. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Today, many commodities are trading at relative lows. And now you can take advantage with EverBank's new limited-time, 5-year, market-safe currency comeback CD. This indexed and U.S. dollar-denominated CD offers 100% principal protection and is based on the equally rated performance of currencies of Australia, Canada, Chile, Mexico, and South Africa. These five countries are especially rich in commodities, and their respective currencies are poised to do well should commodity prices begin to recover. Keep in mind that no APY, or periodic rate of interest, is paid on the CD. Don't miss out on this innovative new financial opportunity. CDs must be opened and funded by the upcoming July 14th deadline. To apply online and learn more about the CD, including product terms and disclosures, visit everbank.com/TFNN now. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished up 129, NASDAQ up 36, S&P's up 15. And, you know, I think most of us, you know, as you go through life, you really wonder why our medical costs are so high. And, you know, I've talked about this, not a huge amount, but plenty of times. When you have a third payer deal, which we have, folks, bottom line is that the pharmaceutical companies get away with murder, the hospitals get away with murder, and this one's going to be the doctors taking a payoff for some of these. This is almost seems like the congressman for the cheap payoff. So check this out. This was a study that was done. 280,000 prescriptions. The study was done in 2013. So doctors getting free meals pick branded drugs more. So check this out. Doctors who accept free meals from pharmaceutical industry are more likely to prescribe certain branded drugs to Medicaid patients than generics, according to a study published Monday. The article in the JAMA International Internal Medicine documents a group of 280,000 doctors who received industry-sponsored mails. Now check this out, this is what's sad. Typically costing less than $20 in 2013. The study found that doctors more frequently prescribed the four most common brand name drugs that were all available in Medicaid Part D program. In the case, Biostatic, a beta blocker for high blood pressure, physicians who received at least four meals, which is equals $80, chose the brand 5.4 times as often as generics. What was most surprising to me, this is what the person who was doing the study, was that Such small payments were associated with a big difference in the physician prescriptions, said Carly DeJong, one of the study's authors and a research fellow at the Center for Healthcare Value at the University of California in San Francisco. It was previously thought that it takes a certain amount of money to influence a doctor, and the current guidelines are written that way. Drug makers and doctors have long shared a close relationship that recently has become more documented. Last year, the government data, so check this out, this is pretty sick. Last year, government data showed that U.S. doctors and teaching hospitals received $6.4 billion, that's with a B, from drug and medical device makers in 2014. So, you know, it's a common sense deal. If, just picture for a second, that all of us out here, we are either a medical device maker or a pharmaceutical maker, and we gave $6.49 billion, that's in 1 year, folks, to hospitals or doctors. Do you think we want anything in return? They don't only get something in return, folks. It's, you know, this is one of these deals that's like, okay, how long is this going to go on? Because this is legal bribery. It's legal bribery, man. I mean, that's the bottom line. You're talking about $6.49 billion, you know, and anyway. While the industry said it's covering the cost of meals, helps enable communication with doctors, critics contend that their physicians potentially expose themselves to undue influence. The bottom line is that, you know, it's been going on forever. The sad part about it, even when they were trying to, every single time they try to fix the health care in the U.S., no one really just tackles it that it's pure bribery. And that's what it is. It's like the Defense Department. When you have the third-party checks, it's a no-brainer, okay? If you remember, years ago, we were paying, what, $300, $400 for a hammer, okay? The amount of money that goes south is pretty incredible. And inside, whether it's the pharmaceuticals, whether it's the defense, all it takes is paying off the Congress cheap money, you know, and they just basically sign it away, baby. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at Google, because Google, folks, is going to give the NDX100 a problem. And this is what it is. Google on Friday came down with monster volume. Google went from $708 to $688. That $688, which we're hanging at right now, it's $693. Google looks like it not only wants to break its high volume swing low from February, it looks to me like it's probably an ABC down. And the A point on this is 769, the B is 689. So you're talking $80, which would get you into 660. Oh, interesting. And 660 is that high volume swing low. Yeah, it's an ABC down. That's how it looks. Why am I saying that? Because what we did on Friday, you went into this $689.55, which was the low the 28th of April, and we did it with juice. It was 2.8 million. Well, we got into that with 3.4 million. So Google's going to be tough, because now this is what also ended up happening at Google. Remember, we have GOOG, okay? And GOOG is the Class C share. Then you have GOOGL, I think. Is it GL? Yeah. And that's the Class A share. So what has happened inside the NDX 100 is that, of course, both of those move the same way, but the weighting structure, they both have a large weighting inside the NDX 100. And the GL is at 706. That came down to 701. Going into the swing low of 703, breaking it. You know, the 703 swing low had 3.1 million. We broke that with 4.1, and that sets up that, you know, you're gonna go after the February 8th swing area. And in fact, right now, the GL, G-O-O-G-L, that's the Class A share, is only 2 points away from the high of that. So if we bring this back just a little bit more. Oh, this is going to be interesting. So, okay, so the number to watch is $703. $703 in Google. That was last July. We went from 558 to 703. Huge volume. Beautiful move. Because if you get into this 703, let's, when I say get into it, you have to get into it like a good 10 points. Let's say you go to 693, then that's going to be problems in paradise. The reason being is that it, when it went up so nice, when it broke topside there, it went from the 558 to the 703 mark. Let me just see. This probably finished an ABC structure on the way up. So we broke the B, we broke it with volume. So the A point on this would have been, it's close call. If I do the bigger one, let me do this bigger one here for a second, see what happens. 278, no, 318. Okay, it's almost like the 300 bucks, which would have been 790. Yeah, I did it. Okay, so check it out. This is what we did. So Google finished an ABC structure on the way up February of this year. That's what that you have happening. So we'll see. This is going to get wild because if we do get into this 703 number, you can pull all the way back to 539. And guess what? That wouldn't be, he's saying anything's even wrong with Google. All that is doing, that is finished an ABC structure in the way up. It's pulling back to where it broke out from, probably setting up another one on a longer-term basis. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow finished up 129. NASDAQ up 36. S&P's up 16. We're going to be right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge for daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom. Tom? Take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go over to the silver market and take a look at silver. So the gold contract, folks, moving with wide price spread, accelerated volume on the daily, weekly, all of the above. Silver, we still need a bid in silver. What we have at silver is this. Silver was up 9 cents today. Now, we had some nice volume in it, and silver is so highly volatile, this can change in a day, there's no doubt. We are at $17.51. Now, what's cool is that you're right under the low. I suspect, number one, you're going to go after this $18 area. Now, how we take this $18 area out, it's going to be a big number, and this is why. So watch this. This is where this gets really wild. So silver, the gold contract wants to run to $1,428. $1,428, that's your structure, the ABC structure. What that also is that that's just a swing point that it was laying out here since August of 2013. Well, the thing that's pretty cool about silver is this. You can make the case that when silver did take off as gold took off in January, in silver it's April's case. In silver's case, you can make the case that we're at 1750 and that silver broke its downtrend that started, there's a huge downtrend that started in 2011. You know, that's when silver was at $44 rather. But the downtrend that it did break was the high from August of 2013, and that's where gold was also at 1428. Now, it's pretty cool. You know, we broke it with vengeance. We had wide price spread, you had accelerated volume. You never made it back to the bottom of that trend, and now we're going higher again. So how we take out this $18 is a big number, you know, because that next leg would be $25. And if we get silver up at the $25, bottom line is that that's going to be pretty intense. Yeah, the silver market did hit a high in 2011 of $49. At first, I'm looking for this $25. Now, at $25 in silver, there's going to be a lot of, there's a huge supply line there. So we'll see how that hits it. Now, if we go over and do the same exercise in gold, you're going to see gold's a little bit different. What has happened in the gold market is that it not only sliced and diced that area in spades, you're going to see it's the same take, meaning it broke the August 2013 level, and it did it in February versus April. That being said, you're at 1290. We're almost the next swing point is 1392, and the real number though is this 1428. Now, if we bring the gold contract back, what you're also going to see is that is also where, well, actually, it's going to be a little bit higher when we hit 1526. Inside the gold contract is where you're going to, you know, have quite a bit of resistance, because that supply line is huge. That supply line started in August of 2011 and went all the way over to March of 2013. You know, when you do pull this back, though, it's still pretty impressive what we did in the context from highs to lows. And this is why. So watch this. This is going to be really bizarre if this is how this thing shakes out. Well, when you take a look at the contract itself from the highs to the lows, meaning when this whole bull market started, what you had is that we never did a 0.618 retracement. We just did over a 50% retracement. So what is that saying? Well, that says two different things. It says, number one, you can get to the high in gold, which is 1920. $1,920. But more important, it's actually saying you can get over that, because we never pulled back to the $898 level. If you had pulled back to the $898 level on the correction, that would say that that's more than a 0.618 retracement. And if you do more than, if you do a 0.618 or larger, that's saying that it's weak, and most times you're only going to go up to the top and test it. In this case, well, guess what? We didn't get close to that. We went to a price point of 1,046. So that says, number one, you can make it up to the 1920 area, and in fact, you can take it out. So this is going to be wild just watching this whole thing shake out. When you do look at the bonds are saying free money's out here. You know, when you look at the rest of the world, bottom line, that is also saying free money's out here. So we'll see where this whole thing does shake out. But silver, keep your eye on silver. What we did have out here today, as a few of the tigers are elated, no doubt, is platinum caught a bid. The platinum market out here, if we look at the spot market, it was up $15.50. That is saying that you can make that case. You know, we had the sign of strength on the 3rd of June. That's when platinum went from 956 up to 1,020. You pull back. We had light volume on the pullback. It's starting to move again. You can make the case that this is building cars to get up to the 1,090 area, you know. So that's not a bad setup. And what we haven't had is that we haven't had that platinum market get any juice underneath it. The amazing part, folks, is that platinum is the most precious metal, you know. And platinum has been trading under the price of gold for such a long period of time now. But guess what? It has always been more precious than gold. It's harder to mine than gold. And, you know, we'll see if, in fact, it's going to overtake gold once again. Right now, it's still trading under gold by, 215 dollars, which is just amazing. Because when you do look at this on a much larger basis, this number, PLA2, when you see this, well, check this out. I mean, you're talking about, let me get it up. You're talking about much higher. There we go. Okay, so there we go. Okay, so we pull this back, and what you're going to see, this is intense. Platinum traded up to 2301. And then you talk about a crash, went from 2301 down to 744, and that's when gold went from 1066 down to 666 in the crash of 2008. Platinum then turned around, went from 744 back up to 1886, come back again, and this is like a classic, comes back and tests the lows of 2008. And now it's taken off from that particular point. When you actually see many of these, how they've been testing the lows of 2008, if you have high volume lows, folks, and markets have gone up and gone up dramatically, pay attention to those when they come back down and test them. One of the equities, okay, this is, if we go look at Deutsche Bank for a second, check this out. So, you know, bottom line, Deutsche Bank, you know, many folks think this is going out of business. Well, it's not going out of business. It came back, it tested the lows of 1478, and the first test was on volume. The first test in February, yeah, on volume. You could absolutely say it's going out of business, but guess what? It's already tested it this month, and it's not going to have the volume. You're talking about 63 million versus 101 million. You stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up to the date, accurate,
active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at tfnn.com.
Welcome back, folks. And good old the Cleveland Cavaliers, they did it, folks. And they also, this is kind of intriguing, because what they also did is that they delivered the largest audience since the days of Michael Jordan. So that's a long time ago. They drew 30.8 million viewers, making it the most watched NBA Finals game. That's in NBC history. It was also the biggest TV audience for the NBA championship since Game 6 of the 1998 series between the Chicago Bulls and Utah Jazz. Pretty amazing. This also made it a much bigger event because of the fact that what was on against it was HBO's Game of Thrones. Great game, though. If you saw that, that was pretty incredible, man. There's no doubt. Basketball is just amazing that it seems that it comes down to the last 2 or 3 baskets. And, man, whoever gets that ball gets it in, and it's a beautiful thing. That three-pointer, that was pretty amazing at the very end. So what are we going to be looking for tomorrow morning? Okay, so approximately, we get 4 hours, Asia's going to open up. Australia will open up, then Asia is going to open up. If we go take a look at the Hang Seng first, what you're going to see inside the Hang Seng, we are at, it was up $340 last night. Now, I suspect that can go up a little bit higher, maybe $150. That's going to try to test that high out there of the 13th. That being said, Nikkei, different ball game. In the Nikkei, that was up 365, but that didn't have any juice behind it. That also couldn't make it over the highs of last Thursday. That was at 16,082. So what is that set up? That is setting up more pressure on the way down into this 14,800 area. If we go to the yen, we take a look at the yen, and this is where their central bank is having conniptions. The yen continues to get stronger. Now, we're at 103. The yen has gone, folks, from 121 US dollars to 1 yen, to 103. Okay, bottom line, what does that do? That puts a spin inside the Nikkei in general, because stronger yen makes it a lot harder to basically export goods. So the yen right now is at that 103.94 area. That looks like, hey, we get game down to 99. And, you know, we'll see whether it makes a full run all the way down to the lows of 2011. If it does, man, that's pretty intense, because that would be saying that the yen, you know, did a counter trend bounce. So if we bring this yen back, watch this. This is just unbelievable, actually. So when we bring this back, the yen, when the Nikkei was at highs in 1980, I think, yeah, 70s and 80s, it was the 80s, the yen was trading at $357 to 1 yen. Now we're at 103. Well, the lows out there are 79. And guess what? You can make the case that, you know what? It didn't get to the highest swing point of 147. You made it to 125. You know, we'll see how we handle the 96 area. But if you get into 96, which is not that far down from where we are now, this will go after the lows. You go after the lows, you're going to see the Nikkei continue lower. You're also going to see gold continue much higher. I mean, in a big way, too. The correlation is pretty intense there inside the structure of where the yen goes versus where gold goes. The interest rate structure, this is where this gets really whacked out. So if we take a look at the 30-year bond in Japan, this is like sick. 30-year bond in Japan, you can lend the government of Japan money for 30 years and get paid 0.2% for 30 years. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it, step into it, take ownership of it, fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Look forward to speaking right back here tomorrow morning. Wow! Look at them, folks.